As the world advances into the 2030s and beyond, the new generation of warships is set to dominate the seas, reflecting cutting-edge technology and evolving naval strategies. These vessels, ranging from next-generation destroyers and advanced frigates to nuclear-powered aircraft carriers, are designed with enhanced stealth, powerful missile systems, and versatile multi-mission capabilities. So without further ado, let's check out the list of them. The Aegis system-equipped vessel, ASEV. The program aims to introduce two state-of-the-art destroyers featuring the SPY-7 radar system. These ships will offer ballistic missile defense, effectively replacing the cancelled Aegis Ashore systems. Weighing around 12,000 tons each, these destroyers are anticipated to be commissioned in the early 2030s and are designed to counter military threats from China and North Korea. The Miznik, or Project B-106, represents a new class of multi-role frigates tailored to the Polish Navy's needs. Scheduled for service before 2030, these frigates will be equipped with the Sea Scepter naval air defense system, providing protection against aerial and surface threats, including supersonic anti-ship missiles and unmanned surface vessels. The F-110 class, also known as Boniface class, this is a new generation of multi-purpose anti-submarine heavy frigates being built for the Spanish Navy, equipped with the Aegis combat system. These frigates are designed to have a service life of 40 years, provide accommodations for additional personnel, and operate unmanned aerial, surface, and subsurface vehicles. They are expected to enter service by 2030. The Hunter-class frigate. This is a fleet of six heavy frigates currently under construction for the Royal Australian Navy, set to replace the Anzac-class. With a full load displacement of 8,800 tons and a length of approximately 150 meters, these vessels will be capable of exceeding speeds of 27 knots. The lead ship HMAS Hunter is projected to be commissioned in 2034. The Project 22350M, first unveiled in 2014 and often referred to as the Super Gorshkov, is an advanced frigate being developed for the Russian Navy. The ship features an expanded hull with a displacement of 8,000 tons, a pyramidal mast, a 64 vertical launch system VLS cells capable of deploying Caliber, Onyx, and Zircon anti-ship cruise missiles. It will be outfitted for anti-submarine warfare. The lead vessel of this upgraded class is expected to join the Russian Navy by 2030. The Anti-Submarine Warfare Frigate ASWF. This is a joint initiative of the Royal Netherlands Navy and Belgian Navy to replace their current multi-purpose frigates. These new multi-role frigates will be armed with a 76mm naval gun, two Marlin 40mm guns, ESSM Block II missiles, rolling airframe missiles, and long-range anti-ship missiles. A total of four ships will be constructed, with each Navy receiving two frigates beginning production before 2030. The Visby Generation 2. This is an advanced iteration of the Swedish Navy's Visby-class corvette, currently being developed by Saab. This new generation is anticipated to be equipped with a state-of-the-art anti-ship missile system, a torpedo system, and an air defense surface-to-air missile system. Saab was awarded the development contract for this corvette in January 2021, with the vessel expected to enter service with the Swedish Navy after 2030. The Canadian Surface Combatant CSC Program. This program is an initiative by the Royal Canadian Navy RCN to replace the aging Iroquois and Halifax class ships with up to 15 new frigates. The construction of the first frigate is slated to begin shortly, with the goal of commissioning it before 2030. The Korean Next Generation Destroyer KDDX. This is a stealth-guided missile destroyer currently being developed by Hyundai Heavy Industries for the Republic of Korean Navy. This 8,000-ton destroyer will be equipped with the Korean Vertical Launching System to deploy Hyunmoo 3C Land Attack Cruise Missile and SSM 700K anti-ship missiles. it will feature more advanced sensors, enhanced stealth capabilities, and lower operating costs. The KDDX is expected to be operational in the 2030s. The CVX aircraft carrier. This is a proposed class of conventionally powered light aircraft carriers for the Republic of Korea Navy, aiming to enter service between 2030 and 2035. The carrier is expected to operate a fleet of F-35B vertical short takeoff and landing aircraft and will be equipped with a multifunction radar system for ballistic missile defense. Notably, the CVX will be among the few aircraft carriers worldwide to feature two islands. It is projected to become operational in the mid-2030s. INS Vishal, also known as Indigenous Aircraft Carrier 3, this is a planned aircraft carrier for the Indian Navy, to be constructed by Cochin Shipyard Limited. This new design will differ significantly from the Vikrant, featuring an increase in size and displacement. Vishal is expected to be a flat-top carrier with a displacement of 65,000 tons and may include a catabar, catapult-assisted takeoff but arrested recovery system. The carrier is anticipated to enter service in the 2030s. The FREMM Evolution. This is an advanced iteration of the Italian Navy's FREMM class frigates. These upgraded ships will incorporate cutting-edge technologies, including systems to counter drones and the capability to operate emerging unmanned systems. The FREMM Evil frigates will also be equipped with capabilities to defend against tactical ballistic missiles. In July 2024, the Italian Navy ordered two FREMM Evil frigates under a €1.5 billion contract, with commissioning expected by 2030. The Pang. This is a next-generation aircraft carrier program initiated by the French Navy. This new carrier, slated to replace the Charles de Gaulle, is expected to be commissioned in the late 2030s. It will feature a larger displacement, nuclear propulsion powered by the K-22 reactor, and accommodate up to 30 FCAS combat aircraft. The carrier will be equipped with the electromagnetic aircraft launch system and advanced arresting gear, with an anticipated displacement of 75,000 tons and an expected commissioning date around 2038. The Type 004. This is a planned supercarrier with the People's Liberation Army Navy's aircraft carrier program. This carrier will be the first in Chinese fleet to incorporate nuclear marine propulsion and will also include an integrated electro-propulsion system, enabling the use of electromagnetic catapults. The ship is expected to generate sufficient power to operate advanced weaponry, such as laser weapons and railguns, which are currently under development. The F-126 class frigate. This is a planned series of German warships designed to replace the F-123 Brandenburg class frigates in the German Navy. These frigates will be the largest surface warships to enter service with the German Navy since World War II. The first of these ships is expected to be commissioned before the 2030s. The class will be equipped with specific mission modules that include the necessary equipment, space, sensors, and weaponry to perform specialized tasks efficiently. The Type 26, also known as the City-class frigate, this is a new class of frigates being constructed for the Royal Navy of the United Kingdom. Its primary mission is advanced anti-submarine warfare, though it is also capable of supporting air defense and general-purpose operations. The Type 26 Global Combat Ship will feature a new propulsion system that combines 4 MTU diesel-electric propulsion motors to power the ship, along with Rolls-Royce MT-30 gas turbine. The Constellation Class. This is a new series of multi-mission guided missile frigates being developed for the United States Navy. These ships will feature a combined diesel-electric and gas hull, mechanical and electrical propulsion system, marking the first time this technology is used in a U.S. Navy vessel. These frigates are designed to operate within strike groups and surface action groups led by large surface combatants. The lead ship of this class is scheduled for delivery by 2029. The DDG-X, or Next Generation Guided Missile Destroyer program, is an initiative by the United States Navy to create a new class of surface combatants that will replace 22-flight Ticonderoga-class cruisers and 28-flight 1-2 Arleigh-Burke-class destroyers. These ships will be equipped with larger missile launch systems, enhanced survivability features, and provisions with future upgrades in space, weight, power, and cooling. The vessels will initially be outfitted with 32-cell blocks of the Mark 41 vertical launching system, with the overall capacity expected to include 96 standard vertical launch system cells. Well, with this, The Buzz is signing off for today. Stick around for more interesting videos from The Buzz. See you guys next time. Bye-bye.